Hi, Elaine.
Hello.
Thanks for joining me this morning. Can you introduce yourself and tell us a bit about your involvement with the creative arts?
Yeah, my name is Elaine Palmer and I'm a singer-songwriter. I've been performing and recording and touring for probably about 20 years now, 15, 20 years really. So yeah, I've released a handful of records and I played mostly in the UK, but I have travelled to America quite a lot to perform as well.
Brilliant. So has this always been something that you've done? Did you come from a creative background?
To be honest, it's something that I've done, yeah, since I was a child, but I don't come from a creative background at all. My parents came from a very poor family, and both of them, and they didn't really have opportunities to get involved in music at all, really. It just wasn't even in the equation when they were young. So they, even though they loved music, and my dad played lots and lots of old records all the time, and so there was a lot of music played around me, but they weren't musicians. They I'm sure maybe now if they were brought up, and you know, now they maybe would have enjoyed playing and performing, definitely. But no, it was just something that I was very passionate about from an early age, really. It was quite an organic, natural kind of, you know, interest that I had.
And did you pick it all up yourself? How did you learn?
Well, when I was about eight, I showed a lot of interest in the piano. My nana actually had a really old little organ that I think her nana might have had, that nobody really played. She didn't know how to play. I don't know, she just inherited it really. And it was just kind of stuck in the corner of a room in my nana's house, all dusty. And I remember like having a little play on it, and like it was one of those like you know, like those kind of reed ones that you press the pedals to pump the air through. And it was really lovely. And I remember just starting to make little songs up and little tunes on this little organ all the time when I went to my nana's. So that was the first time I ever really played a musical instrument that I remember. And then I remember asking my mum if I could, you know, if we could get a piano, or if I could learn to play the piano. So when I was a little bit older, I got a few piano lessons, but I'm talking like a handful of them. It wasn't, you know, it wasn't something that I was taught. But straight away, I started using the instrument to write songs. For some reason, immediately, I wanted to write words with it and poetry with it. And so that's how my interest in music came, really, as almost like a vehicle to write the lyrics, the songs as well.
I had a quite similar background, and it was interesting. Before you, I was interviewing a guy called Aaron Lythe, and it's been so interesting for me in these interviews to see the difference in the generations, like people of our generation who the arts really wasn't seen as something that they could do as a career, and it's just been brilliant. It's really heartening to see, you know, even people whose parents are very, you know, come from very traditional kind of working class backgrounds, they've been really encouraging of their kids to get into the arts. So that's been fantastic.
Yeah, like I said, my parents didn't have much knowledge on it, but they had a lot of passion for music, and especially songwriters and big voices. And my dad's family all had like wonderful singing voices. They didn't have the opportunity to do much with that, but they were almost renowned for having these big, deep, rich, booming like singing voices. So I guess they just, you know, they just almost sang at family parties, and they would be the ones that would always have to get up. It would be our family that would have these phenomenal kind of crooner voices or whatever. So I guess it's there. It's just, you know, the interest and the passion is there underlying, isn't it? You know, so yeah, it did influence me definitely.
You said you when you first started playing with an instrument, you instantly started writing your own material. Has it always been your own material, or did you do the kind of traditional thing of starting off with covers first and then moving on?
To be honest, For some reason, I always, I was more interested in writing songs, even from very young. I don't know why. I would just make little stories up, little poems up, and I always want to put them to the piano or put them, and then a bit later put them to the guitar. And I did learn a few songs from artists that I really loved, Bob Dylan and maybe a couple of Jeff Buckley songs, or, you know, but very little, to be honest. It was always, for me, there's something about the creation of the song and the telling the story. So that was the bit that, for some reason, always fascinated me.
Mm, great. Have you always worked alone, or do you collaborate?
Well, I have worked alone a lot, but when I make records, I play with other musicians, obviously, depending on the feel of the album that I want to produce. I'll say, oh, I really want some strings in this bit, or, you know, I want to specifically work with a cellist, or I really want really heavy drums. And so I'll work with lots of different instrumentalists to produce, like, you know, to pull them in to make the sound that I want to make. But I haven't written with anyone else before. Not because I don't want to, just because I haven't really ever gone down that path. I think, to be honest, I'd quite like to, really. I think I would probably quite like to do something like that. I don't know whether people have always just seen me as just this, like, you know, Trojan powering down the Elaine Palmer road. So I've never really gone on board to create, to compose, you know, to write with other people. It was only ever really to for them to come and work instrumentally on what I do, what I've written, really. But I've enjoyed, like, writing. Just recently, I've enjoyed, like, writing for film a bit more, and, you know, like, starting to collaborate with other artists on that level. And I've been curating a lot of performances in art spaces, in galleries, and also combining that with some spoken word or some readings. And so I've really enjoyed doing that, like, you know, the combined arts as such. Yeah, that's been fabulous.
Brilliant. Yeah, it's very much my focus as well. And, you know, an outcome of this kind of listening process here is to find people that can potentially collaborate together in big multimedia events. And
that's wonderful. I think that's really a really exciting kind of a way forward as well, because as a creative, I think you can immediately relate and work well with other creatives, because, and also I think you can transcend your work into other art forms as well. You tend to be, you know, able to adapt with other art forms if you have that kind of creative mind or whatever, you know. I've done quite a lot, like I said, with film and video lately, and I set up a project called the Watermill Sessions, where we filmed live performances in front of, like, live audiences in these really beautiful, iconic historical buildings, and the films almost became a separate project as well as the actual live performance. And something really nice about documenting the arts. Do you know what I mean? I really like that. There's something really interesting about that I seem to be quite fascinated about as well.
Excellent. Well, maybe I'll be calling on you sometime next year. It'd be great to get you involved in whatever comes out of this. I mean, until it's all done, I don't really know what it's going to result in. But that seems to be my what I'm hoping for. So I have a club called the Red Room that's always been like a kind of multimedia cabaret club. We're only tiny, but I got a projector because I just thought, you know, that opens up to, like, the filmmakers and animators and stuff, which I think in live events are sometimes a little bit overlooked. So yeah, just want to embrace all art forms, and it's been great to find quite a few dancers as well through this project that I think really bring something to the arts. I remember seeing some poetry events in the last couple of years where they had, like, dance interpretation of the poems, and that worked really well for me. So yeah, and music as well. So it'd be great to bring all that together. Why music? Why have you kind of spent your life dedicated to it? What does it give to you? And what role do you think the creative arts plays more generally in society?
Well, for me, the creative arts are vital, completely vital. And I think they are overlooked quite a lot. I mean, I also tutor a little bit. I'm not a teacher as such. I'm not a classroom teacher or anything, but I do go into some schools and colleges sometimes. And I tutor guitar and piano, and I do lots of like vocal tuition and quite like pop choirs, very contemporary kind of choirs, but mostly for children. And I think that I've always had a little bit of a struggle with that sometimes because of how undervalued it can be in education, and how undervalued like my role can sometimes feel. Do you know what I mean? Where I guess it always depends on, you know, the person that's bringing the music to the school or to the college or whatever, but you can really see the difference in different establishments' attitude towards how important it is. And also I always get these, you know, it's almost like people say, well, why teach your child to play music? What you know, it's not going to get them a job or something. Well, you know, little Johnny goes to football every Saturday. He's probably not going to play for England, but hey, you know, it's like, well, what's the point in anything? Do you know what I mean? It's, for me, it's not just a passion or a joy. It's like, it's a form of like social interaction. It's a form of documenting history. It's a form of expression. It's also how people can interact with each other and communicate. It's a language, you know, and it's a language that's a worldwide language. It doesn't just work on like we enjoy it level. It's needed and in so many different levels. I really do believe that. I think it builds people with a much richer, wider, well-rounded being, you know, into society. And also over time, it's been literally, we've used art to document incredibly vital moments in history as well, and how different societies and different countries have interacted through the arts. So it's just, it's so important and it's so valuable, and it's very precious. And it's almost like a part of human life where you find like the magic of almost, you know, of what the meaning of existence almost is. Do you know what I mean? That's where you find it. You don't find it in the ooh, or this or that or the mundane or how much money you've got in the bank or, you don't find it there. Yeah. So that's, you know, it's almost, for me, it's almost like it is a way of life, definitely.
Yeah, totally. Talking to Sean Shaker, on my radio show a couple of weeks ago, and talking about art, you know, that it's been there since the dawn of human consciousness. And I would even say that perhaps human consciousness developed because of it. And, you know, the early cave paintings, like as soon as we could make a mark, we'd been mark making, we'd been trying to leave an artistic record of our existence. And, you know, when you just think like music, as you say, it's the nearest thing that we've got to a universal language. You can go anywhere on the planet, pick up a guitar, or, you know, just sing by the fireside. And, you know, you just think that, you know, it's what we spend the first 9 months of our existence listening to, that vroom, 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 the whole. Yeah. And we're, you know, I think that's what music does. It takes us back to the dawn of civilization and human consciousness.
Yeah, and it somehow connects people on a level that is sort of almost like a superior consciousness, isn't it? It can connect people from all different forms and walks of life, with all different ages and all different kind of backgrounds. It unites us, and it unites us very effortlessly and very, very precisely, that not anything, and a government can't do it, or none of it works, but this honestly works. It really does.
And coming back to the football thing, you know, even there, it's like, when your team's doing well, or if your team's doing badly, what do? You sing. You all get together and you sing.
That's right. That is so, exactly. And I mean, on a science level, you know, you can look into it and see how it actually boosts parts of the brain, the serotonin, how it can actually benefit children academically. They start getting really good at maths if they're doing an instrument. It's like, well, you know, the stuff there is definitely, on all aspects of what people value in life, there's benefits all the way up, you know, for me, of all creative arts, not just music, but all creative arts, definitely.
Brilliant. Absolutely. Couldn't agree more. So I guess, having been up all jubilant there, the last question that we kind of have to cover is lockdown, and how has that affected your practice? Have you still been able to create? Obviously the gigs have fallen a little bit by the wayside. How's it been for you?
Yeah, so this year's been tough, no doubt about it. You know, I'm not gonna pretend it's not. The touring I was supposed to do has just, everything's been cancelled. I've done the odd little tiny socially distant show, like sporadically in between, you know, different lockdown tiers or whatever. So, but very little at all as far as the live performances go. And obviously I haven't been able to go into schools at all to do workshops and tutor and everything. So financially it's been a massive cut for me. And obviously prolifically how much I do has been a massive cut. But creatively, obviously, technology helps like this, you know. I've been able to record, been able to mix, get people involved in that process as well, sending people stuff digitally, they can come back with this and that. So you can do it remotely a little bit, but it's not something I would opt to do long term, definitely not. Because going back to the human interaction side of things, I feel that I definitely feel like I benefit more with bodies in the room and working and physically playing live with people, and how that can create something that you can't do through a digital device. So I do long to be back out there in a room full of people, and also to create, like, you know, with other musicians live as well, and the magic and the buzz and the, and what you can, you know, what comes out of that is very precious.
Absolutely. Yeah, can't wait to get back out there as well. I'm kind of hoping, I mean, obviously we've got this vaccine and there's hopes there, but I kind of feel like we had maybe a bit of a wasted summer, because it seems like outdoors is safe pretty much, you know, unless you're really up close to people. And I'm hoping that at the very least we can have some kind of outdoor, small outdoor performances, maybe even wee festies.
Yeah, that would be wonderful. Festivals. Oh, it's so weird, isn't it? We've missed a year, but you feel like it was years ago. You know, that feels such a long time before that, doesn't it? It's a really strange thing. Very far in the distance, isn't it? Those wonderful memories.
Yeah, I mean, even looking back to stuff I did in February and at the start of March, it was like, that just seems another lifetime away right now. It's amazing.
Yeah, it does, isn't it? But yeah, I agree. I think that it's doable. It's definitely doable, and I'll be well up for doing it.
Terrific. Well, I've got a wheelable PA. It goes pretty loud. It's got 6 hours charge. So whatever happens, you know, in a very small scale at least, I'm going to be getting out there with that next year. And your space is a performance area as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, definitely. I agree with you there.
It's been lovely talking to you, and hopefully when all this is over, we can go out and meet out in the real world.
Yeah, that would be wonderful. Thank you so much for inviting me to be part of your project.
Brilliant. Take care, Elaine.
And you. Thank you.